Hi. So today is a little bit of a different video, and I'm filming in my room today because it's a rainy day. I have my cute little candle going, and I was just going to kind of talk and explain Hurricane Dorian and our plans like associated with that. This video is a little bit late because we wanted to make sure, like before I went out and made a video about it, we wanted to make sure that like our plans were aligned and stuff. So, as most of you know, Hurricane Dorian hit the Alcos and Grand Bahama as a Category 5 hurricane. It hit and completely devastated it. It hit as a Category 5, but I mean, the winds were like 200 miles an hour, so it would have been a lot more if the scale kept going. It was the strongest hurricane in Atlantic history to ever make landfall, and the eye went right over the Alcos and Grand Bahama. Destruction is just crazy. And it's so sad to see everything that we love and that so many other people love. And it's really sad to see all those things like washed away or blown away completely. There's hundreds to thousands of people missing. I mean, we got so lucky because there are people who have lost everything. I mean, their homes, their livelihoods, their loved ones. The most important is the people. So saying that, I do have a place that you can donate stuff. It's definitely not too late. You still need help and they will need help for a long time. So I have a place you can donate in the description. Also, as most of you know, we have a house in the Bahamas and that house is in the Alcos on Scotland Key. I've made a few videos on it, but not that many. When the hurricane hit, we were in Italy. My dad flew home, but he didn't fly to the Bahamas because he didn't have time. By the time we decided, it was really a last minute thing. Because we didn't think it was gonna be this bad. But he flew to Florida and then he was just gonna try to get a flight to the Bahamas as soon as possible, which is what he did. And he ended up getting a flight like only a few days after from a friend. When he got over there, all four houses, which we have four small little shacks, nothing fancy, just four shacks, but all of them were still standing, which was really great news. And we were like feeling really optimistic at that point, because there's 70 houses on the island that we're on and only about 20 of them were like even in decent shape. And so, you know, going into it, we were expecting to have nothing, but we got really lucky and we do still have four walls on four houses. But when he really got over there and looked, I mean, we did realize the amount of damage we did actually have. You know, roofs gone, walls a little bit collapsed. It's just a mess. A lot of you guys were wondering our plans. We were in Italy and we are actually in Genoa right now. That's because we have to go home. We're shipping the boat home. We just can't continue to sail and travel and have fun while, you know, all of our friends and Bahamian family and everything that we love is trying to rebuild and we're not there. The boat ships. There's a window, either October 25th through November 5th, so somewhere in there. And then we'll fly home and just spend a couple weeks home. We'll probably spend till Christmas or something. Our plan originally was to be cruising and traveling for the remainder of the year until winter and then also next summer. But here's the thing is that I don't really want to go to a new high school in the middle of the year. I know a lot of people do it, but that's just not something I want to do. So I'm going to continue homeschooling for 9th grade. We would be living full-time in the Bahamas, trying to help out and rebuild as much as possible and help the community because that's really home. I mean, we love it so much. I grew up there and, you know, my parents have been going there for years too, and it's just, we live in Florida, but I mean, Bahamas is really our home. We are going to be living there full-time for the next, until next fall, which is like 10th grade for me, so that I can go back to school in the beginning of the year. That's our plan for now. Who knows, we might go sailing again. So you might be asking, Morgan, what's going to happen to your YouTube channel? Are you gonna forget about us? No, I'm not. As a matter of fact, I'm going to continue doing YouTube videos in the Bahamas if you're interested in that, because we'll be rebuilding, helping, just a bunch of stuff. There's so much to do there, and I think me documenting that would be interesting for people to see. So I am going to continue making YouTube videos when we're living over there. A lot of you are very sneaky and notice that the boat was on the market. And that is true. That's the plan, and that is our Hurricane Dorian news, our Hurricane Dorian plan. And yeah, thank you for watching, thank you for subscribing and commenting. Anyway,